Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, hi, I'm Akanksha. So in today's video, you already read the title of the video, we are going to talk about face shaving. If you have to shave your face, how to shave your face, who, or all the various questions. I put a question on my Instagram and you guys asked me a couple of questions, so I'm going to be answering that. I'm even going to demonstrate how I shave my face. So before we go into the video, make sure you hit the subscribe button, ring the notification bell so that you get notified every time I post. It'll mean the world to me. So let's get into the video. Now first let's talk about who can shave their face. I know it's a myth and all, like, you know, people say it's a myth that, you know, if you shave your face or you shave your body, the hair is going to come stronger, like, you know, thicker. But I understand and I feel you guys. Thick hair girls know the problem of shaving. Period. I know people, doctor, everybody say it's a myth that when you shave your hair, it, you know, regrows thicker. But I know all our thick hair girls, whoever has literally thick hair, can, you know, have struggled always with shaving. Let it be body, let it be face, let it be whatever, because we know that it grows back thicker. Like, maybe it's just the normal, but we feel it's way more thicker than waxing. I know that, I've been there. I completely understand if you think the hair will go thicker. So if your hair growth is really thick and really fast, like, it comes back really quicker, it's very pokey, it's very annoying. So yeah, if you have really thick hair, I would not recommend it. I personally do it because I have done laser on my face. I have PCOD and I struggled with facial hair, hormonal hair everywhere in my body, like the normal, wherever hormonal hair issue happens, okay? So that is on my lower chin, like the lower part of my jaw, my chin, my mustache, and everywhere. So back when I was in, I got done with my 12th, I did have laser treatment. I was under medication and I underwent, and like, I even took laser. I was on laser for like 10 sessions. My hair growth completely didn't stop because I have really thick hair, and I used to not go, like, you know, in proper intervals. Like, if they asked me to come back in 1 month, I used to go in 2 months and all. But even then I had really thick hair, and maybe if I went for like more 4 or 5 sessions, it would have, you know, got down to 90% of it.
Between editing, but I forgot to mention the points of, like, a couple of points I'm going to add it right now. So I've done a diode laser. Diode laser is a normal laser, which is very frequent, like, you know, very common in Indian doctors and everything. So that is the laser I have done, and usually that has a lot of procedure, like, you know, it is a little complicated, as in, you know, they shave it, then they put ice pack, and then there's a lot of thing, you know, they take a lot of precautions to do diode. So back then, when I did, diode was very common, and that is what I did during that time, because that's what my dermatologist had. But now there are a lot of different types of lasers. There's super diodes, there's ND Young, and these are like lasers which are really, really effective as well. So it doesn't mean that because it took 10 sessions for me and my hair didn't reduce as much, it doesn't mean that it won't reduce for you also, because I had really thick hair, plus I had hormones issue and all, so that's the reason my hair was really thick. But that doesn't mean that, you know, if you go for laser, it won't be effective for you also.
But now, after 10 sessions, I can tell you this, that my hair growth has reduced a lot, and the thickness of the hair is also, like, you know, gone down a lot. So now the facial hair I have is pretty much like a normal, how people who don't have any health issues or people who don't have a lot of thick hair, like, there are a lot of normal girls who don't have a lot of facial hair, just a little piece first, you know. So my facial hair situation is like that right now. But other than that, you know, I have really thick hair under my jaw, even till date on my chin, and a little on my mustache. So what I do is, I never shave my jaw, I always epilate it. I've mentioned this on my Instagram video as well, you can go check that video out too if you want, but I'm going to explain everything here anyway. So this part of my face has really, really thick hair, so that part of my face I do not shave at all, because the minute I shave it, like, you know, in 1 or 2 days, the growth is going to come back, and like, if I'm sitting like this or something, you know, it keeps poking and it's very annoying. So I don't shave this, and I don't shave my chin, because really thick hair cannot be handled at all. Now, getting back to the point of who needs to shave. Yes, thicker people, I would not recommend you to shave your face. The only thing is laser, dude. I understand it's expensive, but it is the best solution for thick hair girls, and there are a lot of offers going on a lot of times. Like, you know, Kaya or something has like 18,000 for 6 sessions or something like that, so you can go check them out. Like, they had an offer, I'm not sure now, I guess it was Kaya or something like that. And shaving is good if you have really less hair, and laser is the best if you have really thick hair. I would not recommend waxing for the face. It is the worst thing. People get a lot of pimples. It's not good. It sags your face. Like, whenever they pull that wax off your face, it's really, really sagging. So I would not recommend shaving. Threading, I guess it's fine, but you know how much pain can you take? Threading is really, really painful. So yeah, if you have to do something, then maybe go for threading. Do not wax your face. Like, I know people cannot take the pain of threading, so a lot of people go for waxing. But do not, I would not recommend waxing, especially normal wax. And even if you wanna do, you know, face waxing, then go for the peel off ones, which they apply and then just strip it off. Don't go for the strip one. It is horrible for your face. Please don't do that. So now again, there are a lot of people who told me that, you know, they break out after shaving their face. I have personally never ever faced that. So if you're really facing that issue, then please stop shaving your face. Maybe your face is extremely, extremely sensitive. So please keep up, like, you know, please stay away from shaving. Please don't shave your face. So we've covered how many points, I don't even remember. Thick hair people, stay away from shaving. People who are really sensitive, have really sensitive skin, please stay away from shaving. People who break out, you know, please stay away from shaving.
Hi again. So I just wanted to mention that, you know, people who have a lot of active acne, like, you know, a lot of people have active cystic acne, or usually also they have a lot of acne on, you know, around the face. So such people also stay away from shaving. Like, if you want to, you can shave, but you need to be really, really careful, because you don't want to run that razor or the blade on the active acne. It's not going to do you any good. You rather, matlab, you can shave, you know, this part of the chin, like where you don't have any existing or active acne. You can shave your mustache, you don't have acne there. So, but if you have really active acne, then please don't shave or run the blade over that. And one more thing, do not bleach your face. Don't ever bleach your face. I don't know who started this thing of bleaching their face, but please, face, body, never ever bleach your face. It is not good at all. No matter who tells you to, no matter what celebrity is doing, no, don't ever ever bleach your face. It is not good.
Now it's been like more than 15 days I shaved my face. I shaved it before going to Andaman. Like, I went to Andaman on 3rd or 4th, and now today is 18th. So I've not shaved my face for almost like 15 days. I just shaved my mustache, like up and lower lip, for like once in between, because I had to shoot videos, wagera. But then other than that, I didn't shave my face or anything for like 15 days. So we are going to do that right now. Now let's just put this hair back for a minute. Now usually I first just start off with epilating my lower jaw, because I have really thick hair. So epilating is basically, these are like, you know, 1000 blades type of thing, so they just pull out all the hair. It comes out from the root. It is quite painful for the first time when you do it, and I have to do that, because if I shave it, it's going to regrow in like 1 or 2 days, and it's going to be very pokey, very irritating. So yeah, one more option for people who have really thick, like, you know, hair, facial hair, could be epilating. Their face epilators available as well. This is a body epilator. This is a Philips body epilator. I use this because it's just for the jaw and chin. I understand if it can be a little rough for the face, because it's quite painful. The first time you do it, it'll pain a lot. So the face epilator is available as well. Actually, epilator is a really good option to remove your hair, because, you know, it doesn't like drag your skin, or it doesn't do any of the aging stuff. So this is the epilator. I'm going to start off by removing my hair on the lower jaw and my chin. So just switch it on, and you need to just go on the opposite side of the hair direction, and that's it. It's as simple as that. Make sure you hold your skin, and then, you know, start like epilating it. Don't drag it a lot, just, you know, to have the stretch to the skin, just hold it like that. So you can see, you know, there's a lot of hair which came out of my jaw or whatever. So I always remove this from the root. I always do it. I can never shave that part because it's always going to come out really thick and irritating. Now let's move on to shaving. And I've got so many comments about face shaving. So I posted this video on Instagram and it had like some 300k views. I was shaving my face in it and I had a lot of acne. Okay, like I had acne scars, not like existing acne. So many people thought, you know, shaving is causing me acne. Everybody was like, oh, please don't shave your face. You're ruining your face. You are, because of that, you're getting acne, blah, 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 blah. I cannot emphasize it enough. Like, if I really felt like, you know, acne, like, you know, shaving is the reason for acne, like, would I not stop it? Am I so stupid? See, I understand if a few people are breaking out because of, you know, shaving. Like, they noticed it, right? Like, you know, they noticed it, they understood their skin. That's fine. And my face is not breaking out because of acne, and I cannot say that enough. So, now let's move on to face shaving. I just washed my face and I applied moisturizer. I don't have anything extra on. I did apply moisturizer because I don't want my skin to be really dry. When it's really dry, you can, you know, there's a tendency you can cut yourself as well. So I'm going to use this razor. This is the Twinkle or the Bronson, actually the ones I'm recently buying up from Bronson. Like, it's available on Nykaa, Amazon, everywhere. Everything is the same, the packaging is the same, I guess it's just different people selling it, so they have different names for it. Now I'm using this razor, but I would not recommend this razor for people who have sensitive skin whatsoever, because this can be a little rough, and you know, people have sensitive skin, I mean people who get red really easily, people who react really easily to, you know, anything on their face. So please, those people I feel need to stay away from this, because this can be a blade which is a little too rough for them. So those people can use blades from Miniso. Miniso blades are good. I do have one of them, but it's not like, I feel it doesn't remove hair as much as I want to. I maybe just tried the wrong one, but I always, you know, like this. I know it works, so we're just going to go with this. So although I said that shaving does make the hair thicker, that is not true for people who have really, really light hair. So you guys must, like, you know, everybody surely has that one friend who has really less body hair. They can shave it off and then it doesn't grow back thicker or doesn't grow back for days as well. And there's you with such thick hair, you shave it and it comes back in a day. It's really irritating, really pokey. So I feel it really depends on the type of hair you have. The hair on my facial hair, like on the sides of the cheeks and all, is really fine, and I've done laser, so it's more finer now. So people who have very light hair can shave their face. I don't recommend it to people who have really thick, dark black hair. One more thing this blade does is this blade resembles dermaplaning. Like, dermaplaning is something which it's like a very thin and sharper blade than this, but dermatologists use it to, you know, remove all the dead layer of skin from your face. So this doesn't exactly replicate that, but it, you know, this does a similar kind of job, but not totally, you know. That is an professional type of thing, and people do it with a lot of care, and you cannot do that on your own. But this is just going to remove your facial hair as well as exfoliate your face a little bit. So I'm just going to zoom you guys in so that you can see better. Hold your skin up. You need to always have that stretch to the skin. Place it like this. Don't do this. This can cut your skin. If you're a beginner, always start off this way. And so place it this way and just start shaving. That's it. Slowly and steadily. Don't be really rough with your skin. That is all the hair and the dead skin which came out of my two sides of my face. One more question which is asked very frequently is that, how many times do I shave my face? How often do I shave my face? Like, if you're someone who doesn't have a lot of facial hair or anything, you just piece fuzz, you wouldn't even notice the hair until like maybe 15-20 days. So for few people it's even fine, like if you shave once a month. For me, I shave it like once in 10 to 15 days or something, and I even do it because, you know, once the facial hair is off, the foundation applies really, really beautifully. So yeah guys, it is that simple. I just shaved my whole face in literally like 2-3 minutes. It's that simple. Just be very careful. And yeah, don't see this as a form of exfoliation for your skin. It can be a part of it while you're shaving it, but don't exfoliate your skin. Really exfoliate your skin with this. It is going to be really harmful. And aftercare is really, really important. So my face does burn a little bit, like not really burn, but you know, I just, you know, run a whole, like, you know, sharp substance over all my skin. So, you know, it does burn a little bit. So aftercare is really important. If you have like you know, fresh aloe vera juice, please apply it after this. It's going to be very soothing. Don't apply those things which have mixed colors, fragrance and all those things. If you have that plant of aloe vera, just apply aloe vera on your skin and let it be, like, you know, for half an hour to 1 hour. Don't do anything for your face, it, because you know, you just shaved it, like, you know, every time it's like aftershave. Like men aftershave, you know, apply their aftershave gel or something because they need cooling, and if they apply some thing over it, it does burn, right? So you know, you need to take care of it. Don't apply anything for a while. Don't do your makeup immediately after shaving your face or anything. Just let it breathe for a while. So I'm just going to pop on like a hydrating sheet mask or something like that. And yeah, that's it for the video, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and if you did, make sure hit the subscribe button, ring the notification bell, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye. I know it is.
Can you stop making noise?